Hi, I'm Stu, and welcome back to another LumaFusion video tutorial. Today, we're going to take a look at LumaFusion's new stabilization feature. We're going to pit it against Emulsio and also Node Video. Okay, let's take a look at the footage. Now, I've got an 8-second clip here, which I filmed myself, and it's handheld with the iPhone 12 Pro, and I probably will only actually use from about here onwards. So the last 3 seconds is the most important part. For the purposes of this test, we'll stabilize the whole 8 seconds. It's not too bad. A little bit of a horizontal wobble going on, but generally speaking, it's relatively stable. So to get to stabilization, double tap your video clip and then choose stabilize if you're not already on it. And then from there, you've got a choice of 3 basic presets, light, medium, and strong, and also any automatic shutter correction if you want to add light plus shutter, medium plus shutter, and strong plus shutter. And I'm going to assume that's correcting for rolling shutter. All I'm going to do is just switch on lock and load, let it do its thing, and we'll start off with light. Do you see what it does? And medium, which does seem to be a bit more stable, and then strong. It's not bad at all. There's still a little bit of a horizontal wobble, but it's certainly way more stabilized than before. So in this instance, I'm going to go for strong. Tap back. Now we're going to take a look at what Emulsio can do and also Node Video, and then we will compare these back in this project timeline. Okay, we're now in the Emulsio app. I'm going to select the boat video. And as you can see, that's how quick it analyzes the footage for stabilization. We can drop in a stabilized and original. What we'll do is we'll place this horizontally so we can see the difference. Remembering this is a preview, so it's not quite as high quality as it will be when it's exported. Press play. You see the difference? It's definitely stabilizing it. So if we press pause, we can then decide what strength we're going to apply to it. So stabilization profile, we can go for vibration. I'm going to try for cinematic. Rolling shutter, I'm just setting it for the Apple 12 megapixels. Avoid black borders and avoid discontinuity handling. Tap that. We'll angle it off at a 45 degree angle. Move that around that way. I think that's as good as it's going to get for this. Once we've done the stabilization, we tap on share. File type is going to be MP4. Video quality, that's as high as I'm going to get with the bit rate, which is 25 megabits per second. No audio on this. Tap export, and then calls up the dialog box. And we're going to save this as a new video here. Now we're going to pop into Node Video, do the stabilization in that app, and then we'll take a look at all 3 versions back in LumaFusion. Okay, Node Video works a little bit different in that I've loaded on the stabilizer, we've got the video footage here. What you're going to have to do is basically pick a point to track, and I'm going to track the center area of the mask, and then you've got to tap analyze, and you can see where it's actually correcting for the movement by the green wiggly worm line. Tap apply, and then if we play back at this point, but this time on the root of the video so you don't have the markers, I'll just take the timeline back. Now this is slightly different in the way it stabilizes, in that you're going to see the black edges going on here. So we have to make a slight correction for that in LumaFusion. Going to tap export, going to choose 1080 because that's the size of the footage. I'm going to switch it to 24 frames a second. And we're going to make the quality very high. There's no audio, so we don't need to worry about that. And one thing that I don't like about this app is the fact that to actually render this out, you've got to press play, and it just seems counterintuitive. I'd rather have a sort of render or export button, but that's just a personal preference from my point of view. This is, of course, rendering out just now, and video has been saved to your camera roll. Brilliant. Okay, and that's us done. So let's look at them side by side now, and this is where things get a little bit interesting. I'm going to talk you through it first of all, and then I will play it through. But just to start with, I've got LumaFusion on the left, Emulsio in the middle, Node Video on the right, as per their labelling. The first thing I notice about LumaFusion compared to Emulsio or even Node Video is that LumaFusion doesn't crop anywhere nearly as badly as Emulsio, and even Node Video's cropped in an awful lot more. If you're shooting 4K, this isn't going to matter too much, but because I use double take for this sort of animatic for the film that I'm making, it's only 1920 by 1080 HD. So therefore, any kind of cropping is going to be an issue. You're going to actually see some artifacts creep in as you zoom into the footage and scale it up more. Let's play it through. In terms of stabilization, I'd say LumaFusion, again, and I'm trying not to be biased here, looks stabler than Emulsio, and minding the fact that Emulsio used to be my go-to stabilization app, but I would say LumaFusion's looks better, followed by Node Video and then last by Emulsio. And the fact that LumaFusion does the least amount of cropping is probably the reason why it looks the best. So it's kind of interesting. So if we disable Emulsio, we just look at the other two side by side. I really can't tell that much of a difference. If anything, Node Video does look a tiny little bit more stable. Just looking at that horizontal wiggle I've got going on there. There's that little bit of cropping going on, and the reason for that is obviously if I go into my crop, I've had to scale things up to hide the fact that you've got black borders going on, and the way Node Video stabilizes, it doesn't crop in naturally. You can see the border floating about there. Now, if I was using cinematic bars top and bottom, that could actually hide that and help retain quality. But keep that in mind if you're going to be using Node Video. That could be hidden behind just a set of matte bars. Looking at this and taking into account the way Node Video works, I think LumaFusion is your best option. And I'll tell you another reason why. Node Video has a limitation of how many megabits per second it can actually export and render to. Whereas LumaFusion, you're working inside the editor and you're working with the highest quality video. So I would say overall, LumaFusion is going to be my go-to for stabilization. But in terms of retaining quality and speed of use, because it's obviously directly inside the app, and being able to work efficiently as well as output to the highest quality possible, LumaFusion Stabilization by CoreMelt is definitely going to be the go-to going forward. So there we go. That's your little video tutorial for today. If you've enjoyed it, by all means, give the video a thumbs up. It's always appreciated. And if I've earned your subscription today, subscribe to the channel. And don't forget to ring the bell to be notified of a new video tutorial. And I'll catch you on the next one. See you later.